Hello students, in early class we have discussed about the history of taxonomy, that is we have discussed about the historical background of the biological classification. As you know, the classification is the branch of taxonomy itself. When we define the taxonomy, that is the branch of biology that deals with identification, classification and nomenclature. So already you might be studied about nomenclature in the first chapter itself, okay, but here are certain points which are related to the biological classification. As we have already discussed here, you can see here the Aristotle, the first of all biological classification was given by Aristotle in the 384 BC, and he classified the plants as well as animals, okay, or he classified the living organisms into plants and animals. So plants are classified into three main types, that is the trees, shrubs and herbs, while animals are classified into two main categories, the animals with red blood cells and animals without red blood cells. So the animals without red blood cells are called anaema, right, and the animals with the red blood cells are called enaema, okay. So we have already discussed about it. Then one more contribution I would like to put here, that it was not in the previous lecture, but I am putting this one, that is Theophrastus. You know Theophrastus, he was also well known student of the Aristotle, and he was also been referred as the plant or the botanist, okay, he was a botanist. So he studied different plants and he mentioned these plants in his own book, okay, and he classified the plants into four main categories, okay, and which are those: trees, shrubs, under shrubs and herbs, okay, and his contribution was given in during 371 to 287 BC. Next, another scientific contribution which was given by Carolus Linnaeus, which is also been referred as the father of taxonomy, right? He concluded two kingdom classification system. He concluded the organisms into two different kingdoms, that is kingdom plants and kingdom animal, okay. Now, apart from this, we have some more classification systems which were given by different scientists. So we will write on this one by one, okay. I hope you are getting everything. So the another, that is the fourth one, which was given by George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker, okay, it is also the classification is also known as Bentham and Hooker's classification, okay. So it was given by George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker, okay. According to them, the plants, okay, they are classified, or the plants which are the seeded plants are classified into three different classes, okay. So they wrote about the plant in their book, that is Genera Plantarum. They mentioned about the different plants in their book, that is called Genera Plantarum, that is the book wrote by this George Bentham and the Hooker, okay. And what they have mentioned there, that they have given a biggest classification, okay, they have given a biggest classification of kingdom plantae, okay, and or in the natural classification, okay, in their book. They gave biggest classification, okay, they gave biggest natural classification system, okay, so here biggest natural classification system, and they classified the plants, that is the generally the seeded plants, which are called as the spermatophyta. Okay, these are the seeded plants which are having 202 families. Okay, they have classified this into three different divisions. Okay, that is the dicotyledonate, with 165 families. Then he mentioned the gymnosperms, with three families, and finally they have the monocotyledonate. With 34 families. So they have mentioned these three classifications of the spermatophyta with 202 families, and here is the division of the different types of plants, that is dicotyledons, which includes the dicots, then gymnosperms and monocotyledon. But this classification system was having certain merits as well as demerits, and what are those we are going to see here. So merits, we'll write in one side, that is the merits, and on another side we'll write demerits. Okay, so what were the merits? So the first, this classification system, which was given by George Bentham and Joseph Daniel Hooker, was based on the floral characteristics. It was based on floral characteristics. Okay, it was based on floral characteristics, and second, that is, it was a natural system of classification, as there is a indication that there is a involvement of floral characteristics, that means living characteristics. So that is a natural characteristic. So it is included, it was a natural system of classification. Then third merit, that it was based on actual observations. So these scientists have made actual observations, that is experimental observations, and then they have found these characteristic features. So they have mentioned this one, that it was based on actual observations. Okay, so it was based on actual observations. Now what about demerits? So first demerit is that they didn't consider the evolutionary characteristics or the phylogeny of the plant. Phylogeny, that means evolutionary characters. Okay, so they didn't consider the phylogeny. Okay, then another demerit was gymnosperms are placed between monocot and dicot. Okay, are placed between dicot and monocot. Okay, so this was the demerit of the George Bentham and Joseph Hooker's classification system. So this is the classification which was given. Another classification system is also there. Let's see about it. That is given by Eichler, or it is also known as Eichler classification. Okay, so the classification is the first classification which is based. This is the first classification which is based on the evolutionary characteristic features. Okay, so A.W. Eichler. Okay, that is, he mentioned the classification of the plants, okay, into two major groups. And what were the two major groups? Okay, so he first of all he considered the he was the one who has considered for first time the phylogenetic classification. Phylogenetic classification. So what was according to its phylogenetic classification? According to its phylogenetic classifications, kingdom Plantae is divided into, or it is been classified into, two main divisions. That is the cryptogamy. Okay, so cryptogamy are the plants which are having less seeds, or they are seedless, you can say. Okay, means they may have, but the seeds are generally negligible in such plants, or they remain hidden. Okay, they remain hidden. So they also show the hidden type of marriage. And another division was phanerogamy. So the plants which are considered under division phanerogamy were having the vascular tissues, or the seed bearing plants. Okay, and the seeds can be seen in such kind of plants. So the division cryptogamy was being further classified into halophyta bryophyta. These are the classes, okay, and pteridophyta. While the phanerogams were classified into two main categories, that is the angiosperms and gymnosperms. So we know that angiosperms are the flowering plant, that is the seed bearing plant. So they are placed under phanerogams. As I told you, the phanerogams are the plants which are having the seeds, okay, and they can be visualized. So angiosperms are the flowering plant, and these are further classified into the monocotyledons, or the monocots, and dicots. Okay, gymnosperms do not have further classification. In case of cryptogamy, we have again three different classes: halophyta, bryophyta, pteridophyta. Halophyta are further divided into algae and fungi. Okay, then bryophyta are into liverworts and mosses. And pteridophytes into shrubs, herbs, and small trees. Okay, so this was the classification which was given by the A.W. Hankler. Apart from this, we have one more classification system. That was given by Oswald Tipu. So another classification system was given by Oswald Tipu. He also contributed the he also contributed in the field of botany itself. He also classified the plants into two main biggest divisions. Okay, so it was Oswald Tipu. Its classification was also based on the phylogenetic properties. Okay, so he also gave the phylogenetic classification. See, when phylogenetic classification comes, means it is about the evolution from that particular division, what kind of class will occur. Okay, so he classified the kingdom Plantae into two main divisions. One was Thallophyta, and this Thallophyta were having 10 more divisions. We will study about this 10 more division in the next chapter, that is Kingdom Plantae. Okay, then another class was Embryophyta. This Embryophyta was having two divisions. Okay, it was further divided into two main divisions, and which are those? That is Atracheota or Atracheophyta. Okay, Atracheophyta. And means the plants which are without vascular tissue, these are called Atracheophyta. And another one is the Tracheophyta. The plants with vascular tissue. Okay, so these are the different classification system which we have studied today. So in as we will revise this point, or if we summarize these points, we can see from the beginning it was the first classification was given by Aristotle. Okay, he classified the plants into trees, shrubs, and herbs, and animals into two groups, that is the animals with red blood and animals without red blood. Right, apart from that, Theophrastus, he mentioned in his book that about the different plants, and he classified the plants into four main categories, that is the trees, shrubs, under shrubs, and the herbs. Then finally, again we have Carolus Linnaeus, who proposed the two kingdom classification system. This two kingdom classification system includes two different kingdoms, that is kingdom Plantae and kingdom Animals. So he concluded the morphological characters, and on the basis of that morphological characters, he concluded two different kingdoms are present on the earth. The next, another classification was given by the that Bentham and Hooker. Okay, Bentham and Hooker also classified the plants. Okay, and though they classified the plants on the basis of the floral characteristics. Okay, and as they were under their observation, so these characters were natural one, and they divided the division spermatophyta into three different divisions, that is dicotyledone, gymnosperms, and the monocotyledone, and they were having the demerits that gymnosperms are placed between the dicotyledone and the monocotyledone. Then we have the A.W. Eichler classification. Right, Eichler was the one who has used the, for first time he used the phylogenetic classification system. Okay, so He classified the plants on the basis of their evolutionary characteristics. So the first, he divided the kingdom plantae into two main categories, that is the cryptogamy, which are without vascular tissue, and phanerogamy with the vascular tissue. Okay, then he divided into that the cryptogamy was further divided into three classes, that is thallophyta, bryophyta and pteridophyta. While thallophyta is having two different species, that is the algae and fungi. Bryophytes, they are having river worts and mosses. Then pteridophytes, they have the trees, small trees, shrubs and herbs. In case of phanerogams, the plants with the vascular tissue, they are divided into two main types, that is angiosperms and the gymnosperms. Angiosperms are the plants which are having the seeds enclosed in a flower, and gymnosperms are the plants whose seeds are naked. Okay, they are without enclosed flowers. The next, more angiosperms are further divided into monocotyledons and the dicotyledons. Apart from that, we have another classification, that is the Oswald Tipo classification system, which was also based on the phylogenetic relationship, or the phylogenetic, it is also a phylogenetic classification. He divided kingdom plantae into two main groups, that is the thallophyta and the embryophyta. In thallophyta, we have 10 more divisions, and in embryophyta, we have two divisions, that is atracheophyta and tracheophyta. Atracheophyta are generally the small plants, or they don't have the vascular tissues within them, and the tracheophyta are with the vascular tissue. So students, I hope you understood all this concept. In the next class, we will be talking about the Whittaker's five kingdom classification.